Hello, good afternoon, and welcome to The Law. This is your legal light, it is your help law. And I'm your host, Samson Lardy Anyenini. Now, today, we are asking the question, ADR, cheap and effective dispute resolution. Many are quick to run to the law court when they have issues. But the Chief Justice, this week, has been asking us that there is some other alternative that we can look at. That is ADR. But how cheap and how effective is ADR, Alternative Dispute Resolution? How exactly do you approach it if you had an issue and you didn't want to go to court or any other place? We have the very best who will tell us what it is all about and encourage you to resort to ADR. So welcome to The Law. It's your help law, it's your legal light. We'll be right back.
Alternative Dispute Resolution Act 2010, Act 798, Sections 82 and 52. 82. Status and effect of settlement agreement. Where the parties agree that a settlement is binding, the settlement agreement has the same effect as if it is an arbitral award under Section 52. 52. Effect of award. Subject to the right of a party to set aside an award under Section 58 of this Act, an arbitration award is final and binding as between the parties and any person claiming through or under them.
You're welcome. And my guest this afternoon, Alex Nete, is National ADR Coordinator, Judicial Service of Ghana. Thank you very much for making the time to join us.
Thank you.
Great. And also joining us is Martin C. Nwosu, who is a legal practitioner, also specializing in ADR practice. He is with Regent Law Firm, Accra, and he's a senior lecturer at the Ghana School of Law. Martin, thank you so very much for making time to join us.
You're welcome, Samson.
Great. So, as you know, what we always do is that the topic that we treat, we find something that is relevant to it, either a legislation or judicial pronouncement or something like that, and get our guests to begin the discussion by spending at least 2 minutes to explain that, so that by the end of the program, if you learned nothing at all, you would have taken away that particular lesson. Today we are treating alternative dispute resolution. How cheap is it? And is it true that it is even more effective than some other forms of dispute resolution? So, gentlemen, this afternoon, our what we call the Law 101 is on sections 82 and 52 of the ADR Act 2010. Let's start with you. What will be your explanation of this provision?
Well, very interestingly, when parties have a dispute, all they are looking for is a resolution.
Right.
Fortunately, the ADR Act has come to augment, supplement, or add to the resolution that the courts provide. So what these sections are trying to say is that, since you mentioned Section 82 first, Section 82 is part of the mediation section of the Act. And what this section says is that if parties to any dispute agree to resolve the dispute the way they themselves decide, that resolution is as binding as any court judgment. It's as binding as any arbitral award. Now, the interesting thing is that you don't have to go to court to have this binding resolution from a mediation section, which is a part of the ADR process. Now, with regards to arbitration, many people are very familiar with arbitration. In fact, the only difference between arbitration and the court litigation process is that we define arbitration as litigation in private, whereas we see litigation as litigation in public. What it means is that there are rules and regulations governing the arbitral process, which you may not find in mediation. So for that reason, once an arbitrator or a panel in an arbitral process conclude a case, they give what is called an award, which is also like the court judgment.
Okay.
And the award is deemed, regarded to be final and binding. As we go through it, we'll explain the only conditions under which an arbitral award may not be binding.
Okay. Thank you very much. Yes, Alex.
Yes, thank you very much. Just as Martin rightly said, what this implies is that any endeavor between disputing parties at arbitration, at mediation, that both parties at the end of the day authenticate and term as their solution to the problem they are confronted with is recognized and enforceable by the law.
Mm. If you are listening to that, the simplest way to get you excited about this is that you haven't gone to court for the resolution of your disputes, and yet your disputes haven't given it to a panel, so to speak, to do a mediation or to do what you call an arbitration. Once it is over and the decision is reached, it becomes final and binding.
Precisely.
Just in the same way as a judgment of the court will bind you. So that's what the two experts that we have here have just said. How do you like about that? What do you say about that? I suppose you didn't know it was possible that you can sit at home, literally resolve your issue, and yet it will be final and binding. Now, let's go to listen to the Chief Justice, His Lordship Kwesi Enyinyebua, and return to continue this discussion, because you have heard about mediation, you have heard about arbitration, what exactly are they, and how can I do these things without going to court? And when you go to the court, Alex is there. He's got a secretariat. You go to the court and you may be asked to go for an ADR, and he will ensure that you get it. So we'll be right back.
For the last 1.5 decades, the ADR program has, to a large extent, performed impressively by helping the judiciary to reduce the load on the courts by 29,558 cases. This is a positive support ADR has offered to the judiciary, without which this load would have been borne by the courts under more stressful conditions. The good news is that this number of cases resolved at ADR are resolved absolutely without resorting to appeals, which also creates another backlog. I take this opportunity to urge the members of the bar, as the major stakeholder of the judiciary, to cooperate with us as we entrench ADR in our adjudication process. My lords, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, sections 72 and 73 of the Courts Act 1993 at 459, CI 133, and the ADR Act, that is Act 789 2010, makes it imperative that ADR should be adopted regardless of the court, whether at the district court, circuit court, high court, court of appeal, and the Supreme Court. They need to work hard in Ghana to make ADR a preferred choice for disputants and their lawyers is now. We cannot afford to postpone it indefinitely.
Right, so, and that was the Chief Justice, His Lordship Kwesi Enyinyebua. So, Alex, coming from where you are coming from, what is the essence of this sort of occasion? You have dedicated periods that you observe as ADR week, and you use that to encourage people to want to use ADR rather than come to the court. People have come to the court. You are working in the court. And then they come to you and say, no, go this way rather. How does that happen?
Precisely, precisely. Mm. The mandate indeed of the court is to really resolve cases by way of litigation.
That's right.
We also have an obligation to institute interventions and adopt strategies to be efficient. And for that matter, ADR has been one of the tools that the administration of justice has identified as one of the ways by which we could be efficient. As far back as 2001, 2002, thereabout, it became clear that the rate at which cases were being filed in court was so huge that the court alone could not dispense with justice without any other interventions. A task force was put in place, and the recommendation of the task force was that we need to look at ADR. And so some processes were, you know, kick-started. And the effect, the outcome from the pilot program was impressive. Mm. And from that very moment, the judiciary had, the judiciary and its partners had engaged in various activities, and to a point that we had to really integrate it and make it a core component of the adjudication process, because ADR had been identified as a very effective complement to the court system. Mm. So when in 2005, the judiciary decided to make ADR part of what we do on a daily basis, we had to also bear in mind that the people we serve must also know that such a tool has been brought on board.
Okay.
And so ADR Week was set up so that every legal year term, we run public engagement, we talk to the press, we allow mediators to attend court in their numbers to do massive settlement exercise.
Okay.
So that majority of court users will really come to terms with the concept. And so what you saw being done last week by the Chief Justice was one of the usual legal term activities being ADR Week, which this time we had opportunity for the Chief Justice himself to lead the team in Kumasi.
Right.
Yes.
Right. And so somebody may be watching us now who may have some case in the court but may not have had the opportunity to become aware of the ADR Week. What then, when does it happen, and what does the week mean to litigants in the court?
The week gives litigants the opportunity to go to the court to say that I've heard of ADR, I want to try it. So that week is entirely devoted for mediation. So in most of the courts where we have ADR, they do not sit that week. The judges only sit in their chambers. Mm-hmm. And so the courtrooms and every corner that are available that could be used by mediators are given out to mediators for as many disputants as possible who are interested in trying ADR to try it for the first time. Mm. And most often than not, when they go, they get results.
Right.
And that is why you could see others, you know, giving testimony as to their experiences in ADR. Again, we also...
Which are the periods?
The period, we have, you know, in our calendar, every week. And so every week in a legal year term, we set aside, you know, 5 days during the week, from Monday to, and it is not a constant date.
Okay.
But as the space will permit, we fix an ADR week in a legal year term. and that week is celebrated nationwide for over 131 courts.
So there's 1 week dedicated for this exercise within a period of 7 months.
Yes, you know, when after Christmas, January to April, where we observe Easter, within that period,
we have one term. Okay.
And 1 week within that period is dedicated.
That's right.
From Easter to Christmas, we have another.
Okay.
Then from October to the following, the end of July, the following year, we also have...
So there are three
terms. There are three terms.
Okay.
Within the legal year.
There will be a week each.
Within...
dedicated for ADR.
Precisely.
Okay. Does that mean that if I didn't get the opportunity, perhaps this week, I didn't hear that this was a particular week for ADR, and that week is expended, it means I can't come to the court and tell the judge that my case, I want to settle with this other person, so we should...
What explore. We mean by ADR has become a core component of our adjudication process is that on a daily basis, people can access the services of ADR in our court, even in the Supreme Court, where we don't have a dedicated mediator. The Supreme Court down to the district court has as part of its, you know, services, ADR, and whenever the need arises, whether it is an ADR week or not, a Ghanaian or a non-Ghanaian who is accessing the services of the Ghanaian court can ask for ADR. And if the case in law is amenable to ADR, then of course nothing will hinder your access to ADR services.
So remember, he has said something that we will need to also clarify and interrogate. It says, if the case is amenable to ADR, does that mean that not all cases can be, you know, resolved through ADR? But the Chief Justice says something, and I'll come to Martin shortly. The Chief Justice says something. He said that in the decade and a half that you started this dedicated process in encouraging people to resolve their matters, some 29,558 cases
precisely
have been resolved through ADR. What that means is that it has lifted some burden from the judicial, the court system,
the court
itself.
Yes.
So what would you say have been the benefits?
The benefits is that the judge has had a lesser load, thereby enabling him to concentrate on more contentious cases and other cases that are not amenable to ADR to do excellent job there. Hitherto, the load was obstructing him. His attention is divided and all that. Now ADR is taking care of those that are amenable, reducing the load, so you have time to commit to those that really need attention of the judge. What it also means is that it's shortening the lifespan of dispute in the court for the disputants. It also meant that it saved them time and cost.
That's right.
Because even if you pay one CD anytime you go to court, and you go to court for 10 years, that together will amount to some huge sums of money.
And 10 years is possible?
Yes, it's possible,
to
yes.
Mitigate.
So up to 28 and 40 years. And in this case, we have a case that was in the travel from the High Court up to the Supreme Court over 20 years. And the day it was referred to ADR, at the sitting, the case was resolved.
A case has done over 20 years through litigation.
Through litigation.
Then it is referred to ADR.
ADR.
One day.
Assigned to a mediator. A mediator invited the parties and they started interacting as to what the solution should be. And less than 2 hours, that 20-year-old
case,
litigated case, terminated. And the parties were happy, shook hands, and thanked the mediator for doing that magic.
Let me go to Martin. Now, we'll come to that point where the other essence of it is where Alex just ended, that the parties concluded this case, shook hands, and went together, like, happily. Whereby, if they had ended the case with the straight litigation, the judgment would have been pronounced. You have won, you have lost. And one will go happy, one will go unhappy. And that can also lead to all sorts of things. Now, if you heard Alex say that a case can do 20 years or even 40, he's not joking. There's one case. It's called Adumakwa Nane versus Nana Usu Ajiman and seven others. It started in Kumasi on the 4th of April, 1974. Guess when it ended? It ended on the 26th of February, 2014. How many years? 40 good years. He's talking about the court where they practice what they call the court-connected ADR. You are the expert who is teaching this and have practiced this many years of your life. How do I resort to this ADR when I haven't gone to court?
In fact, that is where the news gets even sweeter and better.
Oh, rather.
You know, in court, there's what they call the due process. Mm. I call it due process. Because once you enter the court, there is procedure to be followed. Mm-hmm. In fact, sometimes it might take 3 to 6 months before a case that you have filed in court appears before the judge. Now, if you had gone to a mediator in private within that period, sometimes within a week, the matter would have been resolved. Mm. And as we indicated earlier, the resolution is effective, is binding, can be executed through the court process. And that is the essence of Section 82. Mm. So the education we are giving people today is, if the case, as we indicated, is amenable, and I hope we'll get some time to ascertain cases which are amenable and those that are not, please don't go spend time, add to the course load, to go through the due process only for the court after 6 months.
Due process. Please remember, he said the court goes through what is known as due process. But he has decided to call it due process because of the troubles you go through. Yes. Don't go quote it anywhere that he says the court, that's a due process. Yeah.
Thank you. Thank you for that amendment.
Right.
You know. So all we are saying is that, you see, lack of knowledge is killing a lot of people. Mm. ADR is beautiful and easy to access. They are private mediators. I remember as far back as 2002, the first ADR, private ADR center, was opened in Ashaiman. Mm. It is still working there till today. At that time, there was no court in Ashaiman. I wonder whether there was even a police station. Mm. And you know, Ashaiman is a very prolific suburban community. So you can just imagine the number of conflicts. And people started accessing justice through this center. And today, the center has multiplied. In fact, just last week, we went and inaugurated one known as Muslimi Arbitration and Mediation Center, started by some group of Muslims. Okay. And they are working wonders. People refer cases to them from the north, from Kumasi, from all over. So the simple story is this. The law, the ADR Act, makes provision for parties to access ADR in the private section. And this is where we are inviting lawyers, to whom parties will normally consult, to now do some kind of due diligence. The parties will normally, lawyer, for Asamno Koko, take this matter to court, I'm sick and tired, I want to punish the other party. Now, it is up to the lawyer to now look at the case and tell the client, these days, it's not every matter that should go to court. Look, even if I should take this matter to court, after some time, the court will tell me to go to mediation. Mm-hmm. So why don't we look for some of these private mediators and refer these matters to them? And the good thing, why mediator works magic, and Alex referred to it, a matter 20 years after the Supreme Court, when the parties were given the opportunity to interact, to communicate, to dialogue together, they were able to ascertain their own differences, and that is the magic of mediation. And within a short term, they will be able to resolve it. Mm. But when you are talking through a lawyer, to be assessed by a judge, these people know next to nothing about the pain and the realities of the matter. Mm-hmm. Like somebody said, was being cross-examined in court, and the lawyer was putting it to the gentleman and said, lawyer, she, upu tumia, upu tumekwa. I said, Nisi, you know, now we know.
Yeah.
So it is the
you and I were not there.
Yes,
yeah.
So it is the parties. They say, he who wears it, feels it.
Right.
Most of the time, all disputants are looking for is an opportunity to dialogue, to talk to each other. And when they are given that opportunity, invariably, they find a solution.
I discovered that as you speak right now, you talk about that the parties met for the first time and they ascertain their differences.
Yes.
What we are told is that when they go to court, you are fighting for your rights. Mm-hmm. So it is rights we talk about. I have a right here, I have a right here. But I understand in ADR, you don't talk about rights.
No,
what do you
no.
talk about?
In ADR, what you talk about is interest. And it's very interesting because once you start ascertaining the interest of the various parties, you may realize that they might be fighting about this gadget.
Mm-hmm.
But what they needed it might be different. One party needs to just make a quick reference. He can just come and grab it depending on the urgency of the information he's looking for. And the owner might, why do you want to spoil my... Oh, please, I just want to make some quick reference. Now, with this kind of approach, do you think the owner will insist in preventing the other side from taking it? Once he realizes that you want to use it momentarily, he will release it to you.
Mm.
You finish what you want to do, give it to him with thanks, okay. And both of you are happy and smiling. So this is the whole secret of it. But in court, it will take so many years, sometimes several months, for the court to do the portion they call direction.
Mm-hmm.
What the court call direction is trying to ascertain what are the issues in dispute. What is it that the parties are fighting for? But this question, the moment you enter an ADR office, the first question the ADR officer will ask you after you have all settled, what are we here to discuss?
Mm-hmm.
So straight away, the parties will identify their respective issues within which are bottled down their interests, what they need. In fact, interests are needs, concerns, fears that people have, and we all have it in various
ways. Right. Again, you had just mentioned that when they meet the mediator, so that is mediation.
Mediation.
And then earlier you had spoken about, when we're talking about Section 52, you spoke about arbitration or arbitral award. Even though the law in Section 82 says that the settlement that the parties reach in the mediation is final and binding. And then if it's an award, that is the effect that it has.
Mm-hmm.
So explain to us what is the differences, what are the different modes that are used in ADR? Explain that to us.
Thank you. Now, in ADR, we have different mechanisms.
Okay.
So, in fact, we normally talk about alternative dispute resolution mechanisms.
Okay.
So, there are different mechanisms or approaches.
Mm-hmm.
Now, the commonest approach in ADR is what we call negotiation. In fact, with negotiation, if parties will have a little patience for each other and talk about their differences, they don't need a mediator, they don't need to go to court. But what happens for whatever reasons, once parties have difficulties, the tool they need to resolve that difficulty, which is talking and communication, breaks down.
Mm.
In fact, you don't even want to see the person's face. You don't want to talk to him. So how would the problem be resolved?
Mm.
So because of that difficulty that parties face, negotiations doesn't normally work. So where it fails, then a mediator will come in. The simplest definition of mediation is assisted negotiation.
Okay.
So the mediator comes in to help the parties dialogue.
He's not coming to decide for you.
No, he doesn't decide for them.
Okay.
He's coming to help them do what they have been able to do on their own.
Mm.
So the mediator is actually an assistant negotiator, if you want to put it that way. So by asking them questions, oh, you said you needed the iPad to look make some quick reference. He said yes. Oh, so do you really have an objection for? Oh, he didn't tell me. He just came and grabbed the thing. You know, these gadgets, they are very expensive. If it has fallen down, then the guy says, I'm sorry. So now, do you have any objection him using it? The obvious answer would be no. because the thing was just sitting there. Mm. I'm not using it for the moment, so he can do his quick reference. So, you see now, with the aid of the mediator, the parties have communicated. They have understood each other. Now they have received their various interests. The interest of the owner of the iPad is to ensure that it doesn't break down. The interest of the one who wanted to use it is that momentary research, that quick Googling, like somebody said, glue. Googling of a particular information he needed. Now with this intervention, you see the two parties smiling. The one who wanted to use it for the research haven't done, oh, thank you very much, Alex. I'm very happy he's gotten what he wants. Alex has his iPad back.
Okay.
So that is what
so mediation is. That's mediation, which you say is assisted negotiation.
Precisely.
Yes.
Let me also add this very quickly. Normally in this country, and with what pertains in court, when we talk about ADR, I can say it is about 90-95% mediation.
Okay.
So what we call court-connected ADR should actually be court-connected mediation. Alex is here and he will confirm that most of their work is mediation. Arbitration is normally, arbitration has had a much longer history in this country.
Okay.
In fact, we had an arbitration act which dated as far back as 1961. The Arbitration Act of 38, which had been rendered redundant by the ADR Act.
Okay.
And arbitration, the people will normally agree. Arbitration is normally for big-time business people. In fact, today we even recommend it for small-time business people as well, because they agree. They don't want to go to court for various reasons, that when we have a dispute, rather than going to an open court, you know, the court is public, anybody can come and sit in and listen.
Mm.
But with arbitration, the parties agree that we will find an arbitrator who is like a judge or an umpire, who will help us navigate or find a solution to these disputes we are having.
All right.
And that has also been found very relevant, because parties in an arbitral process will normally have something in common. They might be businessmen, worker, employee, and so on and so forth.
So myself and somebody, we have a land issue. We can't agree about who is the owner, or I bought the land. Somebody too says he also bought it later, and we all have documents showing that we have all bought the land from one chief, and we want to resolve the issue. First, why should we look for a mediator, use ADR, rather than go to the court? And how do we access an ADR process without going to the court? You do that first, and then I come to Alex, how they would have done it.
Good. Well, as I indicated, with the private mediation centers or setups, there are a number of them in town. I've referred to to what is happening in Ashaman, for instance. And then right in the center of Accra, there are a number of ADR centers. And people can seek assistance from these centers.
So you must look for an ADR center.
Look for an ADR center.
Okay.
Yes, there are a number of them. I'm sure if you Google ADR centers in Accra, you'll find a number of them.
All right.
Okay. So that is one way to start. And like I indicated earlier on, once you do that, the process will kickstart almost immediately. Whether land issues are amenable to ADR, because the question is there. Land documents are always there to guide the parties. Sometimes when the parties are quarreling over a parcel of land, it's either maybe a certain difference, a certain small overlap.
Encroachment.
Which might be about 10, something the parties, if the attention is really brought to it, they can easily resolve.
Okay.
Or it is even possible that even though they are fighting over the same land, once you get an expert to look at it, maybe a mediator or somebody conversant with land adjudication, you'll be able to tell you that, look, your land, from the coordinates I'm looking at, doesn't even to be here. It is somewhere else. But the person who sold the land to him showed him this particular location. But the documents shows that it is elsewhere. And lo and behold, you might go to that elsewhere and find out that land is there waiting for you. No. So looking for the appropriate places to go when we have a problem is very, very critical in how early we achieve a resolution.
Okay. So
just to round it up very quickly for you. So I have talked about three processes, negotiation, mediation, arbitration. One very important one that our law allows for is what we call customary arbitration. which is also part of the act. Mm. The interesting thing about Kashmir arbitration is that it is the easiest to access. It is the most widespread in the country. And if you look at the law, it makes it very, very easy for parties in dispute to appoint a Kashmir arbitrator. In fact, the simple qualification for a Kashmir arbitrator is the person agreed to by the two disputants to help resolve their problem. You don't need a degree in law. You don't need to be a mediator. Once the parties have some confidence in you that you can help them, that's it. A Kashmir arbitration process.
The two of us, we have an issue.
Yes.
Alex is close by, or is some Ebusian Penyin around the place. We have some respect for him.
Yes.
Or we believe that maybe because we are talking about land, Alex deals with some land issues around the place. He's capable of resolving it. Once the two of us agree that let's go to Alex to resolve it for us.
That's it.
That's customary arbitration.
That is, yes.
And it can be resolved.
And it's applicable to even the regular mediation.
And the end result is final and binding.
Yes, it's also enforceable by the
enforceable.
What do you mean by enforceable by the courts?
Enforceable because the agreement that the parties reach at the end of the day can be filed in court. So that if the one party decides not to do what he has
obey already, it,
then the court can enforce it.
Just as a judgment of the court is enforced.
Exactly.
It's analogous to a judgment.
Are you hearing that? Are you listening to that? You have a dispute and there's someone you respect, you think can resolve it. Is it the same with we deciding that a chief should take over and deal
yes,
with it?
More yes, or less.
That's customary arbitration.
Yes. That's right.
And it's resolved?
Yes.
Okay, so in case we are not able, because we are angry, there is anger in us, we can't see eye to eye, so we don't negotiate. We don't appoint, we don't look for an arbitration center, a mediation center for somebody with expertise to help us, or we don't use customary arbitration or whatever it is. And then we file a case and it comes to the court. How do the court-connected ADR system help us to go back to ADR rather than spend 40 years fighting in court?
If you look at the demeanor of the court and the demeanor of the three successive chief justices
right.
towards ADR, you can infer that the court itself is praying that when there are issues, they should start it from the private sector.
Jaseni Yabu says
yes.
And he was actually telling the lawyers that they should help.
They should
and
help.
And that going to ADR doesn't mean they will lose their fees.
So, our court-connected ADR program is designed as a tool for the judge to manage his cases.
Okay.
So, if the parties, for want of information or whatever, file their case in court, and the case is ripe for mentioning, the judge has the option, as a manager of his caseload, to recommend to the parties and their lawyers that I've looked at your case and your case is amenable to ADR. I give you 2 weeks, 3 weeks, maximum 1 month, go and try ADR.
This is now what has been formalized by CI 133.
Precisely.
So that it gives the judge a power.
A power.
Where normally, initially, the judge would have done it by discretion.
That's right.
But now the judge has the power. That before we do what is known as directions, it must be assessed whether your case is a case that can go through ADR. And then the judge will direct that you go for it.
That's right.
Okay, so where do we go for it?
So CI 133 it has expanded the frontiers of our ADR program in the court.
Mm.
Then, even if it doesn't work at that level and the case is mentioned, the judge still has that option to recommend that counsel, in view of ABC, I'm giving you 2 weeks, go and attempt settlement at ADR. We have mediators in our registry. Your case is hereby referred to the ADR officer for assignment to a mediator.
Okay.
So it is taken up.
What if the judge doesn't say it?
If
we
the
have
judge,
the opportunity to say we want to try.
If the judge does it, then the parties as we discuss this, if you get to know that, oh, there is now ADR in the court, anytime you go to the court, whether the Supreme Court or the District Court, you just raise up your hand. My Lord, I've heard of ADR, and I want to find out if nothing prevents my case from being referred to ADR. Kindly do so for us. The education we are offering Ghanaians is that when you ask for ADR, that doesn't mean that your case is bad or you are afraid of your opponent. What you are simply saying is that you understand the essence of time. You understand how to save money on litigation and all that. That is simply the information we are sharing. And so these are the options.
Hold it there for me. And that's a very interesting note where I want us to take a quick break and return. Are you one of those people who feels that trying to seek a settlement means that the other party will think my case is bad? That is why I want us to settle. He says that seeing that there's an opportunity to settle rather means that you have, you know, you understand the essence of what? Time. You don't want to waste time. And if you try and it doesn't settle, what will happen? We'll get to that. This is The Law. It is your legal light. It is your help law. And today we are looking at the question ADR, Cheap and Effective Dispute Resolution. My guest star, Alex Nete, who is National ADR Coordinator, Judicial Service of Ghana, and Martin Nwosu, who is a legal and ADR practitioner. He's with Regent Law Firm here in Accra. He's a senior lecturer at the Ghana School of Law. We'll be right back. You're welcome back. This is The Law. This is your legal light. It is your help law. And my guest this afternoon, Alex Nate, National ADR Coordinator, Judicial Service of Ghana. There's a secretariat for court-connected ADR here in Ghana, with actually a superior court judge being at the helm, right? We used to have the late Justice
Mafusao
being in charge.
Justice Irene Charity Labi.
Okay, is the one in charge. And also Martin Nwosu is also a legal and ADR practitioner. He also teaches at the Ghana School of Law this particular subject matter. He's with Regent Law Firm here in Accra. They are assisting us to answer the question whether or not ADR is cheap, effective dispute resolution mechanism that we should all look to. They have explained to us negotiation, mediation, arbitration, and told us what the law says is the agreement which is binding and final, just like a court judgment. And if a party wants to misbehave after you have reached the agreement, that agreement can be enforced by a court of law. A matter of 20 years or more took only 2-3 hours to resolve after the parties agreed that they would want to resolve it by ADR. Yeah, so you were talking about how you are the center where matters are giving directed, and then you are able to step in.
Yes, so when you file your case in ADR and within the court it is referred to ADR, you have at most 30 days to conclude the matter. Yes. When within the 30 days, you are unable, but the prospects are high, you go back to the court to seek an extension of time to enable you to conclude.
All right.
And all those who have taken advantage of that have really benefited by way of saving time, cost, and all that.
Right.
And above all, they resolve the case the way
they want.
They want. They create their own solution.
Yes.
And the solution they create does not need to please or satisfy any president. That, oh, this case was resolved this way by an expert. And yours is similar, so resolve it the way it was done. No. If it is pleasing unto them, if it is consensual, if it is mutually acceptable to them, it goes. So you heard the Chief Justice saying that these 29,000+ cases that were resolved absolutely.
Mm.
They do not even come back to ask the assistance of the court for enforcement.
Mm.
Because the parties voluntarily offered that solution and they authenticated it. So implementing it is easy.
And they use absolutely, and he added that not amenable to appeal, means that the case ends there.
It ends there.
It won't go to Court of Appeal. It won't go to Supreme Court. It's over.
So the impact on the system is so huge, far-reaching.
Okay.
Because you don't say that at trial level you resolve a case, and in a month it resurfaces at appellate. From the appeal court, it goes up again.
Right.
And even after the Supreme Court, people are still contemplating something else.
Yes. Now, Martin, so if we are giving opportunity, that's in the court situation, and we are not able to resolve, what happens? Does it not mean that maybe we have discussed the weaknesses of my case and somebody has gotten to know the weaknesses of my case and they will use it against me when we are going on?
No, not at all. In fact, this is where the ethical concerns come in when you apply or when you seek refuge in alternative dispute resolution. The law is very clear on how the game should be played. You know, ADR is usually very consensual, very confidential, so people come and they tell you what they wouldn't have told you in open court. Now, once they have made these disclosures, if for one reason or the other they fail to reach closure and the matter goes back to court, you can't make reference to any of those discussions that were made at the ADR table. Similarly, if you cannot even call the mediator as a witness to come and testify. Look, this man, when we came before you, he admitted that he had done A, B, C, D. Now, incomplete, the mediator is disqualified. You can't, you know, bring him before the table. So once this process fails, you start, like they say in law, de novo, you start afresh, as if nothing has happened. So we encourage this person to try this approach. It works. And I'm happy to observe, as Alex mentioned, that it is not only the court that will look at the facts of the case and make the reference. The parties themselves, and you know, when people go to court after a while, it's like prisoners. They learn a lot of things on the corridors of the court.
That's right.
So they hear about ADR. They meet people whose cases have gone through ADR and they finish it within a very short time. So they can go to the court and then just raise their hand and say, my lord, can my case be referred to ADR? If the other side doesn't oppose it, according to the law, section 64.2, the reference will be made.
And by the time now let's come to matter, what are the matters that cannot be resolved through ADR? And viewers, we understand that this normally would have been the time that would have opened the phone lines for you to join. My guests have graciously agreed that we will do a part two where we have enough time opening the phone lines for you to ask all the questions you want to ask. So please, any questions you have, note them down. And when next they come back, you can ask them all your questions, clear all your doubts. I read some case, an English case. The CJ raised an issue which is important to me. I want you to look at that before we come to which matters are amenable and which matters are not. Where, because a lawyer had not taken the opportunity to advise the client to take advantage of ADR, that lawyer was punished by way of, you know, making him pay money, cost, for not advising the client to take advantage of ADR. What is the CJ's concern here when he says lawyers should be, because they are part of it?
Because the fact of the matter is, our bar code, which is like the constitution of lawyers, makes a similar provision that if, before a lawyer takes a matter to court, he should explore the other avenues. And in fact, the code says that a lawyer conducts a misdemeanor if he doesn't do that. You see,
a lawyer commits a misdemeanor.
Yes. Let me use the appropriate.
Or it's word. A misconduct.
It calls it a misconduct. Commits a misconduct. Yes. A lawyer commits misconduct if he fails to communicate to his client the terms an effect of any settlement offered to his client or declines to take an available opportunity in the client's interest to reach a solution by a fair settlement out of court instead of engaging in legal proceedings.
The court should be a last resort.
Exactly.
That's right.
So even though it hasn't mentioned ADR, mediation, and so on here, that is the essence of this
settlement.
Provision. So today, lawyers should not quickly rush to court. They should listen carefully. They behave more like doctors.
Mm.
Listen to the patient, know exactly what the problem is, and diagnose appropriately. Because the court is really not the best place for certain types of cases.
So the CJ just thinks lawyers are not encouraging their clients.
Well, but today, I'm very happy to say that I'd be very surprised if many lawyers are not encouraging their clients.
That's right.
Because at least for the past 12 years, ADR is being taught at the law school.
Right.
And I see the passion with which the students participate in this.
Right.
Am I you a student of the
Yes.
Yes. Alex sitting here is a student
That's
of
right.
the course. So many, many lawyers, in fact, are now ready and willing.
That's right.
We cannot blame the old school because, I mean, the earlier generation of lawyers, because they didn't have the opportunity to study.
We have run out of time, but Alex, can you mention what sort of cases cannot be settled by ADR?
Oh,
then, just a list of them. Then when we come, we'll start on that note.
All criminal cases of felony are not amenable to ADR.
Felony. Which means misdemeanor is
misdemeanors are allowed
okay.
to go to ADR.
All right.
You cannot also go to ADR with an application for the interpretation of a statute or an aspect of the Constitution to be interpreted. Under our law, Section 1 of it, there is also a mention of an environmental case, which Martin and others have reservation about.
Yeah, we have a debate about that.
Yes.
And matters of public interest,
yes,
national or public
interest. That's right. Mm. And child custody cases in which sexual abuse and what have you, yes.
Okay.
Apart from that, any kind of commercial case, land case, matrimonial court.
In fact, in the commercial court, it says compulsory to
precisely.
Try that first. If it doesn't work, before there will be a trial.
That's right.
Okay, so this will be a good note on which we bring this the curtains down on today's discussion on ADR, Cheap and Effective Dispute Resolution. My guests have been Alex Nate, National ADR Coordinator, Judicial Service of Ghana. Martin Nwosu is legal and ADR practitioner at Regent Law Firm Accra. He's a senior lecturer at Ghana School of Law. I'm Samson Lardy Anyenini. Remember that they have agreed graciously that we'll do a part two where we'll open the phone lines for as much as 30 minutes for you to ask all your questions and get your doubts clarified. Have a good afternoon. This is The Law. It's your legal light. It's your help law.